And why can I say that? Because I am sick to the back teeth of British nationalists perpetuating the myth that Scotland could not afford to thrive in the world as an independent nation. Let's be clear. Scotland is a hugely wealthy country with unbelievable potential. Google it if you don't believe me. Ask yourselves, why would Westminster want to keep us if we genuinely were a financial burden on the purse strings of the United Kingdom? Now, in sharp contrast to that, the UK has spent the last 7 years missing its own fiscal targets, squandering growth and talent through austerity, and now plans on leaving the world's biggest single market and closing our borders. We need people to know exactly just how high the stakes are here. Think of the talent this country's already losing. 38,000 people leave Scotland already for a multitude of reasons. But for many people, it's because they can't get the work they need here. Scotland needs and wants immigration. And I include my own colleagues in that, whether it's Chris Stevens having to go down to London to fight for workers' rights, or whether it's Philippa Whitford talking utter sense to a room of Tories jeering her, or even the intellectual giant that's my group leader, Ian Blackford, who only yesterday I watched make a speech in this very hall only to have to leave early so he could catch a flight to Westminster to be shouted at and dismissed. The importance of effective media as a critical component to democracy cannot be underestimated. So I want to know why the Scottish Conservative leader was invited on the Andrew Marr show to talk about our conference at great length, and I want to know where our invite was during their conference. And I mean this with all sincerity. Catalonia, for example, has 24 hours a day, 7 days a week news channel. Scotland asked for an hour-long TV news programme at 6 o'clock on BBC One with international UK and Scottish news, all presented and broadcast from Scotland and from a Scottish perspective. Now, we didn't quite get that, but we certainly have made steps in the right direction, and that is welcomed. But I think we're capable, and I think we're deserving of more than that. Now, I spoke to Paul Kavanagh, the wee ginger Doug, recently, who reminded me that at the time David Torrance said that the Scottish Six was the holy grail of the independence movement. And there we were thinking the holy grail of the independence movement was a better Scotland, but thanks to David, we now know it's an extra half hour to Jackie Bird. Now, I'm being facetious, of course, but I honestly don't think that it's unreasonable or abnormal for the second largest country in the United Kingdom to desire its own publicly owned public broadcaster. Now, I welcome criticism from the media, as we all should. It's how we ensure an honest and informative debate, but that includes the media too. Far from trying to shut down the media, we want to open it up so that it can reflect all the different perspectives through which people in Scotland view the world, precisely because we know that the stakes are so high. Because the truth is, there's actually another reality of what our immensely rich, creative and talented country is. Currently, we have 52 open and operational food banks in Scotland. More than 1 in 4 of Scotland's children are officially recognised as living in poverty. When the Tories came to power in 2010, around 61,000 emergency food supplies were given to hungry people. Last year, that number was over 1 million. And of those, over 400,000 were children. Families now earn less than when the Tories came to power. Under their watch, workers face the worst decade of wage growth in 210 years. Now, just to put that in a perspective, this is the worst decade of wage growth since the Napoleonic Wars. That's how bad this is. The UK is now heading towards the biggest increase in inequality since your actual Thatcher. That's how bad this is. This is no longer a case of trying to explain why austerity isn't working to the Conservatives. This is now a case of explaining the truth, The Tories are knowingly and willingly driving people into debt, into poverty and into hunger. And the real question is, can Scotland afford not to be independent? Now, some people have said that the thought of independence is scary, that the idea of stepping into the unknown is a daunting idea. And that's understandable. It's our job to change that. That responsibility lies with us. We need to find a way to give people the confidence they need. But I tell you what, we might know what we're stepping into. We might not know where we're going, but we sure as hang know what the hell we're walking away from. Some people say that they're sick of hearing about independence, and that's fine, but the facts are undeniable. We quickly saw the promises of the Labour and Conservative parties disappear before our eyes. We were fed a pack of lies during that referendum. HMRC jobs would only be safe in the UK. That was a lie. Shipbuilding would thrive in the UK. That was a lie. Voting no was the only way to ensure membership of the EU. That was a lie. Pensions would only be safe if we voted no. That was a lie. That we would be treated as an equal partner, yet we've been ignored at every possible turn in the most arrogant of ways. And all the while we're being fed cliches about how you can't eat flags. Well, you can't eat fresh air and broken promises either. The reality is that the UK is an economically selfish, increasingly xenophobic, cruel and reckless Britain. It is a sinking ship. And I'll say it again, are we really saying that we won't get on the lifeboat for fear it might not work? And some people are saying that we should put the independence on the back burner. Why would we ever? We should never be scared to talk about anything in society. The idea that because we had one vote on the matter, we can never exercise our democratic rights on the matter ever again is utterly ridiculous. If you believe in the United Kingdom so much, then why be afraid to ask the people of Scotland the same question again? Yes, there are people who will always vote no regardless. There are people that are loyal and sentimental to the United Kingdom no matter what. So let me say to those people, you will still be able to vote no as freely as you did the last time. But why should we ever fear debate and democracy in action in our country? Independence has never been about flags or borders or nationalism or thinking we're better than anyone else. That narrative has been deliberately created to minimise the appeal of a diverse, brilliant movement that fights for a better future. Independence is about vision and hope. It's about being free to build the kind of society that we want without hindrance. So let me tell you this. The one thing that the Scottish branch of the Labour Party do serve to do is to remind me every day that they are what we must never become. Let us reject the career politicians. Let us reject misleading Scotland to settle for less than it's worth. Let us reject cheap slogans. Let us ensure that we are always unapologetically radical, determined, and that we lead the way. And above all else, let us remember that we are a team. We have to keep believing in ourselves. We have to be bold in our answers. We have to be confident in our arguments. We have to give people that vision of a better future before we can ask them to vote for it. So let's get our chins up and remember that, yes, we are up against it. We are up against the establishment that was once the most powerful in the world. You could even say that we're up against a Goliath of sorts. But I know who won in the book I read. So let's get out there and let's get our independence.
And that'll bring us to the end of the show for tonight, except for the final song. And this time I'm going to play out with a song for my wife, who is still recovering a little bit. You may or may not know that my wife's actually Italian. She isn't called Angelina and she isn't a waitress. However, her name sort of rhymes with Angelina, and this song has also always given us a little laugh. So this one's for her. Get well soon.
I eat antipasto twice just because she is so nice, Angelina. Angelina, waitress at the pizzeria. I keep soup and minestrone just to be with her alone, Angelina. Angelina, waitress at the pizzeria. Ti voglio bene. Angelina, I adore you. Viva you bene, Angelina, I live for you. In passione, you have set my heart on fire. But Angelina never listens to my song. I eat antipasto twice just because she is so nice, Angelina. Angelina, waitress at the pizzeria. If she'll be my cara mia, then I'll join in matrimony with the girl who serves spumoni, and Angelina will be mine. C'è la luna, mezza mare, mamma mia, mamma. Figlia mia, cutterara, mamma mia, pensaccio tu. Si tu doni alla musicante, iti vai, iti vene, sembra lo strumento in mano te. Si ci piglia vanno se lo strumento, figlia mia. Oh mamma, zoom, zoom, baccola. Oh mamma, zoom, zoom, baccola. Oh mamma, zoom, zoom, baccola. Zoom, 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 baccola. C'è la luna, mezzo mare, mamma mia, mamma mia. Figli mia, cutterara, mamma mia, pensaccio tu. Se tu non ne abbisci a olio, e tu vai, e tu vieni sempre baccola la maradena. Se ci picchi a fantasia, baccola la maradena. Oh, 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 mamma. Oh, my mama.